All right, and now some continuance with the Chinese astrology and its importance and significance. Now, right now we have the 7 billion plus, 8 billion, 9 billion plus in China, in Asia, really heavy into it. And I mean heavy. That's a lot of people. It's a lot of people churning up the belief. Okay, we want to be naysayer. So we have all these people churning up the belief every day. Oh, you're a tiger personality, so that's the way it goes. And that's 7 billion people saying that, you know. When we talk about meditations, or these group meditations across the world for peace and blah, blah, blah. Well, right now, that is a form of it. That is a form of intuitive meditation by a huge group of people in a belief. Okay, so that they are going to affect. They are going to affect us, whether we want to believe in animals, our animal selves controlling us or not. They are going to affect us greatly. So, this is kind of funny, a kind of a foo-foo off to regular religious sport of Catholicisms and Christianity. And Judeas, just because you guys don't have the power, you don't have the force. When we're talking, that group of people, that's a huge group of people, with all the same running belief, and you know, and here I am, you know, just like, wowed. I'm wowed by it, because it starts to ring bells about this person, about that person. I'm like, oh my gosh, I start to see them in a completely different a new light that I already knew, but it starts to make that light blossom. So here we are with our signs, and remember the force and energy behind those signs. You know, we've got billions of people that are believers. So the power of belief. What does it do? You know, what does it do? You know, talk about those healers that are out there and they you know, heal somebody and they're saved. What does the power of belief do when you have billions of people all just like, oh no, you know, you would never have a wedding assigned on that day, ever. You would only go and pick your most lucrative, your most auspicious day. You would never ever have graduations on certain days. You wouldn't do this on another day, you know. And then you wonder, you know, sometimes you see pictures of the Beijing drivers and you wonder why they're such bad drivers. Maybe it all has to do with they get a little too much into the warning of today was the day maybe I'm not supposed to drive the car, but I'm out anyway. And then they get like, oh, hectic into it, that dang, you know, nervous, you know, things can befall upon them extra. And so when you start realizing that, you can see it happen to yourself also. Like today is a lucky day for me, a fair lucky day. So for me, in my existence at the moment, that means less fighting, less aggression, absolutely. That just means a more peaceful day. So it's wonderful. But on the other days, on the non-lucky days, yeah, you can look for frictions with people. You can look for chances that you're going to just be a klutz and fall off a ladder. I took a risk the other day. I climbed a huge ladder, and I'm like, well, maybe I shouldn't have, you know, maybe I shouldn't have. But then there is the power of that belief also, that it could make me trip and fall. So you, if you've ever seen the videos of the Beijing drivers, of how they're going through the stoplights and the stop signs, and it's just like chaos. They are hysterical, and I believe it is this energy, this animal energy. That we share. So we don't share, we don't want to share. And some people like, stay away, you know, I'm not compatible with you at all, but I'll tolerate you. But really, nobody, even with compatibilities, we're never like the zero, don't ever talk or look at that person. It's never that bad. You know, you look at it more as a percentage of time you can spend with. You know, if somebody is 30% with you, then you can have 30% of an agreement. If somebody is 50%, or 50% of an agreement. If somebody is 80 or 90%, then yeah, you're very much compatible. So there you go. But yeah, let's remember that energy that's behind it. And you can't blow it away. You can't blow it off. It's an energy that is never going to stop. We have Asia, and they are these animal signs. They've come down to the past 3,000 years BC. They were using the twines of this and the twines of that. They were using the elements, and they were all bringing it all into order. And it is the gods. The gods called the animals to the earth, and the first 12 that showed up, Tantarya, we are ruled by them. So that is the premise. So yeah. So don't defeat your animal. Don't defeat your animal at all. Don't naysay it. Absolutely, start looking at the plausibilities of hey, wow. My dad likes to hunt at the night sometimes, you know, go out and look for possums. And that is indicative of the tiger. A tiger would do that. You're not going to find a rabbit doing that. You're not going to find the oxens. You're going to find tigers. So it's very cute. You can find things that start to be like, well, my gosh, it makes sense. You know, it just makes sense. And yeah, so I'm loving it. I'm just loving it. I find a lot of agreement. And you have to keep your mind open. You have to keep your mind open. And of course, online, I find a lot of these astrology sites can just be like, well, they just have to throw a smattering of this like and this hates and this likes and these hates in. And I think over time, we will readjust and things will become better and smoother. Right now, I think it's a little bit of a mess out there. I think we will have a smoother understanding of just what a wood snake is, or just what a golden ox or a golden rat represents. And like for me, it says the pigs are not really my compatibility. I'll always find something wrong with the pig, and I find that's incredibly wrong. Because one of my favorite opera singers is a golden pig, and that's impossible. That would be impossible, because I find nothing wrong with her. I think she's gorgeous and wonderful. But yeah, so there will be things, you know, and so I don't want to take everything, you know, and just make it that you know, set in stone that no pigs for me can be friends. But yeah. Anyway, well, good luck to you guys. I am so happy with it. I'm so happy with it. Yeah, and I'm happy with the 7 billion of you and your wonderful animal energy. Thank you also.